Good day, guys. Before we start with the constructions, please be ready with the following instruments: ruler, compass, pencil, ball pen, protractor, and bond papers. Okay, so how do we construct the bisector of the line segment? And how do we construct perpendicular lines? Use a straight edge to draw line segment. Okay, so let us draw line segment AB. Okay, locate these points and name this point A and point B. These are the endpoints of line segment AB. Okay, get your compass. Position yung compass in such a way that the compass point will be at point A, and then open the compass, which is approximately 2/3 or more than half of segment AB. Draw an arc intersecting segment AB. With the same compass opening, place now the compass point at point B. Just the same, intersecting segment AB and the previous arc. Now the arcs intersect above segment AB and another intersection below segment AB. So let us name these points of intersections point C and point D. Okay. Now get your ruler and connect points C and D. Okay, let us name the line now, connecting points C and D, line M. Okay, so let us measure now the distance from point A to the intersection of line M and segment AB, the same compass opening. As you can see, parehas po yung kanyang sukat. So we can say now that line M bisect segment AB at point O. So the intersection will be named now point O. And it is also now the perpendicular bisector. Okay, so the distance from point A to point O is equal to the distance from point O to point B, or segment AO is congruent to segment OB since parehas po ang kanilang sukat. Okay, so segment AB is perpendicular at segment CD. And M now is our perpendicular bisector. So again, M is the perpendicular bisector of segment AB. Let us continue, but this time we're going to construct now parallel lines using the same figure kasi itutuloy lang po natin. Again, get your ruler and let us connect these two points, point A and point C. Okay, there you go. Let us also connect these two points again, points D and point B. We know that when we talk of parallel lines, the two lines must be equidistant. Parehas po ang distance mula sa umpisa hanggang sa dulo. Okay? So as you can see, nandyan po mula sa start, ang distance po between line segment AC and line segment DB ay nasa 50 millimeters. Therefore, we can say now that segment AC is parallel to segment BD. We are done now with the following constructions. Bisector of a line segment. We were able to construct parallel lines and perpendicular lines. Now this time, let's move on to angles. We are going to construct now the bisector of an angle. So, first, we're going to draw an angle. For uniformity of work, let us draw an acute angle. Okay, when we talk of acute angle, it must be less than 90 degrees. Kaya makikita nyo medyo nakayuko siya. And let us name our angle, angle A, B, C. So, nilocate po natin ang mga points mula sa sides, dalawang sides, and meron po tayo doon vertex B. Set the compass opening, wag po masyadong malaki. Position the compass point at the vertex point B. And draw an arc intersecting sides BA and side BC. And let us name these intersections point X and point Y. Okay, so again, get your compass. This time, with a compass point at point X, draw an arc, a small arc at the interior of angle ABC. Okay. Next, ang kaya natin po-position ang next? Sa C ba? O sa Y? Siyempre, sa Y. So, balik tayo sa Y kasi yun ang opening po na kinuha natin. This time, intersecting that small arc at the interior of angle ABC. So, there you go. Meron na pong intersection yung dalawang small arcs natin. And let us name this intersection of arcs point D. Get again your ruler. Connect our points. Point D, which is at the vertex. And point D, yun pong intersection ng small arcs at the interior of angle ABC. Okay, let's find out kung equal po ang ating measure ng angles natin. Okay, so the first angle measures 20 degrees and that is angle CBD. Okay, manipulate po ang ating protractor. Move po natin sa zero reading scale yung side ng ray BD. There you go. So, angle ABD measures also 20 degrees. Okay. So, angle ABD is congruent, that's the symbol, to angle DBC. Okay, what makes us say that they are congruent? Kanina minessure po natin. So, we can say that they are congruent because the measure of angle ABD is equal to the measure of angle DBC. Therefore, we say now that the angle bisector of angle ABC is ray BD. So that's it for those who were able to finish these four constructions. Congratulations! You did a good job! Sa mga hindi naman, just watch again this video. Sabi nga, try and try until you succeed. Thank you for watching and subscribe for more. See you in my next video!